I started playing the guitar when I was 6 years old. That's all I've ever done. I'm now 39 years old. So I've been playing the guitar 33 years, almost every day of my life. This is all I've ever done, is pick this guitar. So having that focus at such a young age, I think, was a huge benefit to me. Some people might see my name on many albums and say, what a lucky guy. Part of it is luck, but also part of it is because that's all I've ever done. I don't know if you can see this, but my finger is curved. Can you see that? That's from holding a guitar pick so many years while my hands were still forming as a child. So these hands are the hands of a guitar player.
I gave you that one, didn't I?
Yeah, you did. Yeah, I got that one on the bridge in the video. And then you go.
Yeah, this one. Get the right string.
See, my problem, there's two ways of making notes on Larry's guitar. You have this way, then you have this way. Mm-hmm. See, because Larry knows some kind of weird way. The difference between this and that, you know, he's got it like metered out.
This is B flat.
Right, that's it.
Just,
oh, hell, they're just happy because it's all over.
All right.
Time to go play, get down.
Thank you.
What the heck, we'll play some more music. Here's Strikes Twice. We'll be right back. Thank you very much. I don't know if the, I don't know if Mark or Jimmy or one of the guys in the Yellow Jackets told you, but this is our last night of this extended 6 to 7 week tour. And you know, we have mixed emotions about it. We're glad that it's the last night, obviously, because it's been a lot of hard work. But on the other hand, I'm gonna miss those 8 and 10 hour bus rides, aren't you guys? Oh boy. Anyway, I can't think of a nicer place to end the tour than San Francisco. I mean that. We thank you all for being here tonight. Before we play any more music, let me introduce the guys to you. I'm so proud to have these guys in the band. Doing his first tour with us right now, he's a CBS recording artist. He just plays the heck out of the saxophone. Please welcome Mr. Kirk Whalum. And on drums, boy, I tell this story every once in a while, but I knew John back when he was about 22 years old. He came over to my house one Sunday night, a little young cat. I said, well, let's play some bebop. He played some bebop. And we've been making music together off and on for the last almost 10 years now. On drums, Mr. John Ferraro. On bass, Mr. John Pena. And last but definitely not least is the guy I always call my right-hand guy, and he doesn't mind me saying that. We go all the way back to Disneyland, 1968, red jackets, black ties, and people eating ice cream under the Carnation Plaza. I've known Terry, it seems like, forever. On keyboards, Mr. Terry Trotter.
And I said, guys, I don't have a title for this tune. And one of the gentlemen in the band looked over at the clock and he said, it's 10 p.m., let's call it that. Just that simple, 10 p.m. Thank you.
We'll be right back.
The last record that I made was 1984, before I started my acoustic career. So I had been off a little over 2 years. And then with the decision to make an acoustic guitar record, I think all of my melodies came out different than when I was playing the electric guitar. So I composed this little tune at the piano, and I didn't think I had a melody for it. And the song went, dun, 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 dun. The night of the session, all the guys came in and I had everybody's part ready to go, and I had never played guitar to this song yet. I said, guys, I'm not sure what I'm gonna do. I don't have a melody yet. They said, that's the melody. So I doubled my piano part, which I had written, and that was Smiles and Smiles to Go from my Alone But Never Alone record.
Thank you.
when I recorded my friend's record in 1984, that was the title of it, I invited Al Jarreau to be on one cut, and Joe Sample played on one cut. And I called B.B. King and asked him if he'd like to play the blues with me. Well, I own my own studio down here, as we're in it now, room 335. B.B. said he'd love to come over. The gentleman pulls up in a limousine in front of my house, and I had met B.B. prior to this and spoken to him many times, but we never really hung out. My hand was shaking when I went out and said, "Hi, B.B." He came into my house. My son was sitting on the steps, and that's the first time Travis James, my son, he was 3 years old at the time, that's the first time he'd ever seen Dad play the blues, and it was with B.B. King. What a thrill. So I named that particular song way back then, Blues for T.J.
A one, two, three. Sent from up above, she's the turns of faces.
When I was 14 years old, I got turned on to jazz music. And there were two musicians at the time, one of them a guitar player, Joe Pass, that captured my heart. The other one was John Coltrane, the saxophonist. And John Coltrane went through so many different periods in his musical life, and I followed those periods. He went through periods where he played all outside notes that my mother couldn't stand having in the house, right? Then he did an album called Ballads, where all he did was play the melody to the most beautiful standard songs. Then later, I found this record called Coltrane Plays the Blues. The man was a master of all of it, and I was so into him that his blues phrasing has also influenced my playing, along with the way he plays a melody.
Thank you.
I think a lot of you are aware of the fact that during the 1970s, I made my living playing on other people's records rather than making my own records. Well, over the past 5-6 years since I've been doing my own albums and coming out and touring, people have requested a number of the solos that I played on those other records. So we put together a little short medley of some of our favorite Larry Carlton guitar solos. This first one is the theme from Hill Street Blues, which Mike Post and I won a Grammy for in 1981. And right after that, I'm gonna do two solos, the Kid Charlemagne solo and Don't Take Me Alive from Steely Dan. It's about time, right? And then we're gonna end up way back 1971 when I first joined the Crusaders. We did Put It Where You Want It, so I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
y'all very, very much. We appreciate it.